stuff you don't want to say. All right, so we were talking about how we have had or have not had sex for a long time, right?
Yeah.
So then True likes to chime in, and I'm so happy when he does. So he chimes in and he talks about the times in middle school when him and his homies, how many homies would you say?
Five.
So
including you, or
including or not? Okay, so four of his homies and himself would go to Nod to pick up on these little hyenas, and he had this specific story of what did you do with these little hyenas? This is middle school, man. This is a long time ago. Been erased.
I guess people puberty hits them a little bit sooner. So we were just
I don't want the biologic. Yeah.
We're little horny little kids, and we just go in the Nod, and like I guess we were just too bored, and we're like, dude, let's pick up on chicks. Let's see what we could do. And we were successful, but only two chicks, and it was five and two. So we're just like, all right, well, you know what? Let's be fair, and let's all take turns.
Fair,
and we did take turns, and the girls were down, and we were just like amazed, and we were so happy because think about it, two girls were down to make out with all your homies. I think that's pretty freaking cool. Yeah. And I was just like, hell yeah, we're gonna make out with her, and then I'd be like, your turn, homie, your turn. How was it? And I'd be like, but then I think about it, like, is that me making out with my friends? Because it was
for sure.
So I damn,
it makes you gay.
Got it, thank
damn,
you.
Hopefully not.
So what's your definition of making out though? Because I know, like, in that age, like, people don't even know how to French kiss.
Oh, no, dude, we were sticking tongue, like, it was everything. Yeah, we grabbing, like, oh yeah, it was pretty, like, intense, yeah. And we did it in the train and in the photo booth. You know there's not just like a train where you could get a chill?
Yeah.
That's what we hooked up. And also in the photo booth where he take pictures. Like, we'll be outside like security guards. Like, you're cool.
Oh my God. And was it two girls and then two guys at a time? Or were you guys separate?
No, because there's two photo booths. So it was like a girl and a girl. And then it was like two homies. So it was like, what was it? Three guys outside. So, like, making sure everything's cool, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, that shit was a lot of fun.
Did they ever tell you who was the best kisser? Or you guys didn't even care?
Nah, we didn't even care. We're just like, dude, we hooked up with two chicks and we all hooked up with her. So like, everyone left happy, you know? It wasn't like, all two homies, all you hooked up with the chicks. Oh, you're the cool guys. Now it was like, we all did it. Hell yeah.
That's fair. All right, so speaking of the homies and the true homies, there was this other time you told me about.
The true homies.
The jerk-off session.
All right, this is I think before when me and my buddies I guess we first discovered like what jacking off was, and like,
we were
you could
like
actually
23.
Come. Yeah, my buddy he would steal the Playboy magazine off his dad's between his mattresses, and the Playboy issue in the front was China. I don't know if you remember China.
Ew,
she was a wrestler.
Yeah,
she was fucking gross, but like, I remember there's some other hot girls in there, and we all took turns, like, everyone had their own picture. We'd rip it out and be like, yo, let's like,
you guys would rip up the Playboy,
and we'll look at it, and we'd like start like doing our thing, you know,
like, but in
we
a
made
circle.
Sure we didn't look at, yeah, no, it was like kind of like abstract. Like, one guy was on like side of the corner of the bed, the other guy was in like the desk, like.
So in one room, five dudes,
and then
everyone's in
no,
their own
it
little.
Like five, it was only four dudes this time.
Oh yeah, my bad.
Yeah. But we didn't look each other in the eye. We made sure that didn't happen, you know.
You just looked at each other's dicks.
No, we didn't even look at each other's dicks. Like, we just made a position where we didn't like. We were just like doing it.
So was it super quiet, and you just hear heavy breathing and just?
We had music on, but yeah.
Hey, what song?
I don't even remember.
Did you? Could you hear your homies coming, like busted nuts?
Well, okay, like, I didn't come, but like supposedly two of my homies like were coming, and they were just like they didn't even like, you know, like, I guess when this is so weird.
We're here to park for the expo side.
For the what?
Expo side.
You can turn it
there. Turn it here, right? Okay, thank you. Same thing as the truck behind me.
Okay.
It's cause like now I know like how, like what I like, what I do when I come now. But like back in the day, it was like, it was different, you know? Cause you didn't come that much. It was like mainly like pre-coming. You thought that was coming.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Oh shit, this little white clear shit's coming out. I'm coming, you know? But in reality, it wasn't that. Cause a few years later, we figured out like the real, what real coming was, you know?
The whipped cream?
It was fucking messy.
The sour cream.
The sour cream.
Do any of you guys have stories like that? The self-discovery with your homies?
Not with the homies. I knew older, my friends' older brothers would do that, but they'll do like...
They jack each other off?
No. They'll do one at a time, though.
They'll use chopsticks? What?
they'll give them like time limits. Like, all right, you got 5 minutes in the room, bro. And they'll play the porno like tape.
They'll jerk off and then they'll be like, I'm done. The next guy will go in. But these guys, the Mexican, they all crump up in one room.
That's nasty. Yeah. Well, hey, Mexicans like to do shit together, all right?
Yeah, as a team.
No, that's not actually nasty, Chiro.
I know.
I never had a fucking DJ session with my girlfriends.
Part summer.
Wait, you never?
No, fool. Not with my girlfriends. That's weird.
But you never had a friend that would like,
nah,
will hook up with five dudes in one night?
No, I didn't kick it with those girls.
Wow. Or you knew of?
Well, yeah,
you
I knew.
You were at a party and you're like, oh, this chick's hooking up. Like, she just came out of this room with this guy.
I was a loser, man. I didn't even party.
I mean, I was a loser and I partied.
I don't know.
You're not a loser.
What about you? Do you have any of those stories?
What kind of stories?
Would Churro just anything?
Jacking off with friends?
Yeah.
No, that's too gay for me.
All right, well, shit. We'll end it here because we are at the CrossFit Games now. CrossFit Games, and we're gonna go visit some of our friends, see what's up, support. Let's see if they're here.
Did you finish that beer?
So first stop, caffeine and kilos with our friend Charlie.
Good to meet
you. We're just meeting with a couple friends, and I think I made the worst mistake of my life by dressing this way. So the shirt's good. The shirt, we're good. But look at the pads. Thick as fuck too, so I'm just like, holy shit, I think I just made a crazy mistake dressing this way, because everyone else here is wearing short shorts and a sports bra, and I'm like, you're freaking smart for thinking that way. I think I fucked up. Whatever. I feel so now, since I have boobs, I feel boob sweat falling down onto my stomach, and that's like never happened before, so it's kind of cool to experience it, but then it kind of sucks because I'm wet all over. Whatever. CrossFit experience so far?
It's good. I saw Charlie already. So he's our friend. And I just want to see my other friend, Mike. Silent Mike from Super Training. And hopefully Mark Bell's there. And it's very similar to last year. So I think I got a good scope of what it is and what we should do if we wanted a booth here.
So is this a whole new world for you? Or are you like, yeah, I'm pretty used to this. Like, I know what to expect.
I came here last year, so I'm pretty familiar with what's going on. And we got like really good tickets last year. We got like a little, what do they call those?
Like a private view. Yeah, like a box.
So we really spent a lot of time last year. So this year, I'm trying to get a good scope of what it is. Because mainly I'm not here as a spectator. I'm here to kind of figure out how we can help further expand Barbell Brigade with our team. That's why we have a whole team here. So everyone can kind of absorb the sights and sounds and figure out what we can do to kind of plug ourselves in there.
Smart.
Oh my god.
Ow!
This is my favorite ice cream.
Whoa! Whoa! How dare you? How dare you?
I'm gonna do some thrusters.
How dare you?
Where's Bart?
Hi. Can I have a hug? Hey, I missed you. I missed you so much.
Does anyone know the guy named Bart Kwan?
Hey, what happened to your face,
oh,
though?
This is who I'm here to see.
I hate you so much.
I love you.
I hate him so much. Saul, I'm so nice to him.
You're gonna have for the real thing. Come on, sister.
Spray my beard.
I hate you. And your stupid beard. You look like you belong in like a Bible story.
Did you say I'm Jesus Christ?
I didn't say that.
Oh, yo. Speaking of modest Yahoo.
How you doing?
Hey, I love your dancing.
Oh, thank you.
On his Snapchat, they're hilarious.
Churro, you know Smokey?
Yeah.
It's Smokey, 100% Smokey.
That's our Smokey.
I got rid of it.
Yeah, what's up with that?
Yeah,
I know, it's like a baby.
You had to?
You gotta finger his beard now. Yeah, he fingered yours.
Beard.
Oh, yeah.
This is what it feels like. I never did it.
That's funny.
You guys did the same height, too.
Oh, that's cute. Hey, yeah, okay, kiss each other. Kiss each other. Kiss each other.
Kiss, 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 kiss.
Oh, hey.
Hey, he wants to. Is it true? We're trying to make him kiss.
So, you were there when Lou and I did the sour straw.
Yeah.
He rips off like a piece. First it was a piece of rice cake this big. And then he grabs a Sour Patch Kid and tries to play that game. No go.
No one's down like you, that's all. Yeah,
they don't want to tickle. They don't want
if you play with a grain of rice, man, that's like, you're kissing, you know?
I know, that's their logo. That's a big ass fan.
Big ass.
No, that's what they're called, big ass fans.
Yeah, big ass.
Sorry if the audio's fucked up, but we're in front of this big ass fan. Feels great.
Can you make it faster?
There you go, touching shit. Children, all they do is fight all day and slap each other. Oh, now they're not gonna slap each other because you know the camera's on. Look at them. Look at them. Look at them. Go, go, do it. Can't take you guys anywhere.
Griff, come here.
How come she's on the couch?
It's because I missed her.
That's fucking cute. The way she has her paw in her hand, like, yeah, and what? And what? We're on the couch, Briggy. We're on the couch.
Hey, don't mess with her.
Hey, Vaughn. What the hell? What are you doing, Briggy?
Well, she could leave if she wanted.
What are you doing, freaky woman? Hi, Fawn. Did you guys party when we were away?
Yeah, there are your shoes there. That's what Meatloaf did.
Meatloaf, what did you do? What did you do, Meatloaf? Oh, he wants more petting. They're kind of lucky and super spoiled because, one, we bought them their beds.
You see him? He keeps going, I give him a little bit.
Oh my God, he was about to cry. Do it again.
I think I did it for a while. A little bit.
I think he had enough. Maybe he's, I don't know. Don't look at him with your freaking black raccoon eyes.
Okay, there. He's over it. No, I was saying, so they're...
Oh my God.
They're super spoiled, I know. They're super spoiled because they're indoor dogs, for one, which is awesome. Two, they all have their huge individual beds. That's whoever's they like
that
to change.
In the middle of the living room.
That are, yeah, I was about to get to that. That take up most of the living room. Look at that. And then, because it's been so hot these days, I leave the AC on for them and only them. Like, we struggle at night. Nadim, you don't even have AC in your room, right? No, but these spoiled little babies, they sleep with AC on.
I sleep out here sometimes. It's so hot.
You should just sleep out here.
I do. Like, I just, I can't stand my room sometimes.
Because it's so hot?
It's too hot.
Look, has Nadim ever failed us with the poses? Never.
It's too comfortable.
Never.
Like, yeah, it's cool. I got to live with dogs now. I never got to live with dogs. I have a dog. So I feel like these are my dogs too.
For yeah, sure. What is Fawn doing?
I'm licking her freaking clit.
Disgusting.
Look, Milo's about to pass out because it feels too good. Look at his eyes. Looks Chinese. Chinese shepherd.
Little Chinese
like
shepherd.
His little tongue keeps coming out.
I like when you go to the vet and then they're like, oh, look what you have. They go, Milo Kwan.
How cute. When you go to the vet?
Yeah, they all have your last names.
You yes.
Name. When you think of your last name, you think of Kwan or Carreño?
Carreño.
You still do?
Yeah.
She was just petting my hand. He keeps telling me to give him more.
What? You little needy bitch. Yeah, I always forget it's Kwan.
Look.
I have the camera on you. You little spoiled baby. You still haven't played with the water hose with him yet, huh?
No, but I've seen you guys play with it.
It's so fun. I like wetting his face because he thinks he can catch the water before it hits him. And it's so funny because the other two, they scurry off.
Yeah.
Because they're just so afraid. Yeah, like if they could scream, they're like, fuck that! That's what they're saying, if they could speak, I mean. But this guy's like, yeah! And he comes closer. And he gets right in front of you. You big cutie pie! Did you have a bed before?
Probably not.
Oh my God, you're a king now! Jesus! You're so lucky. What the hell?
He's bending his arm.
Now he's licking his dick, huh?
No, he's biting his little belly.
Oh. Cutie has a little belly.
Now he's licking his dick. Like, hell yeah.
If you could lick your own dick, would you lick it?
I don't know. It's weird. It's like, I might do it, but not tell anyone.
Wait, what?
I don't know. It's hard to say because...
So this is under the assumption that it's not socially acceptable, right?
Is everyone else doing it?
That's what I'm asking.
See, that's what I mean. If everyone else is doing it, probably, then it's normal.
So it's not normal. But you have the ability to do it. Would you do it?
That's what I'm saying. Oh, if it's not normal?
It's not normal.
Probably not.
I feel like you know when you give your own self massage, it doesn't feel as good when someone else gives you a massage? It won't feel as good if you do it yourself.
It doesn't make sense. Jacking yourself off versus someone else jacking you off, it doesn't feel good?
No, getting jacked off feels way better than you jacking yourself off.
I don't need the hand motions, bro.
No.
Is it the same for you? Because I've heard the opposite. A lot of guys have said that they rather just jerk themselves off because they know what they like.
Just yeah, just because they know what they like. But I'm sure if the girl knew how to do the same way as the guy did,
it'd be way better. But isn't it? How does a girl know? Because a girl doesn't know what she's feeling, like what you're feeling.
It's gonna be hard.
Right. So would you prefer? So I guess I'm
so
going.
So let's say if you were a guy and then you could suck your own dick and you were jacking off, then you would have to like let's say you have it on the TV, then you have to like look at the porno while you're sucking off. Or you have like then you pull the porno up on your phone.
Alright, but just say like say your arm hurts, right? And then your arm hurts. You guys bar to massage your arm. Does that feel better than when you have to massage your own arm?
I get what you're saying. Yeah, I would prefer for me not to have to pleasure myself.
Yeah.
But in the heat of the moment, and I'm really super horny, if I could jack myself off, or if I could suck my own dick, like if I had a dick, I probably would.
Yeah, of course.
So you would too?
If I could, yeah.
Disgusting. I can't even believe you admitted to that.
I mean, if you could, I feel like everyone would.
True.
Meatloaf didn't like our conversation. He has removed himself.
The hell?
He's like, I disapprove.
He's like, I can lick my own dick and I don't like it. Why are your shoes on? You know, it doesn't matter. These guys shit themselves and don't wipe their own ass and they lay all over the furniture. This guy too. I was actually pointing at.
Before I even started speaking, you're about to say something.
Well, him too. Probably wipes his own ass. I'm tired. But yeah, don't worry about the shoes. Oh shit. But
I have a wild seal on the beanbag right there.
Your turn. Return it. Return it to him. He says that there's a wild sea. What?
Seal
on the beanbag. But return it to him. What do we have on that side?
A wild seal on the capture room.
Oh.
What?
That's boring.
Sing us a song.
What did you want? What did you want me to say?
Something creative.
Like what? Like we have a wild seal on the capture
room? No.
I just said that.
Yeah.
Like a wild hog.
We have a wild hog.
No.
Or just sing us a goodnight song.
Go sing.
Everybody close your eyes, cause now it's time to say goodnight. And the boogeyman comes
your
head and stabs you in the heart, and now you're
dead.
But you're probably gonna watch this in the morning.
Are you sleepy now?
Me? I'm pretty sleepy.
I'm sing it again. You're hungry?
Yeah.
We ate like a shit ton of food.
That was like an hour ago.
That's like
2 hours ago. Two, 3 hours ago.
About 2 hours ago.
Yeah, when you eat like a lot of pork, it comes out fast. So
it's me a lot of beef or
something the same way. When I eat a lot of beef. Oh, especially beef, dude. When I eat beef. I think that's why I can't eat pork. Because it's so fatty, it makes me shit right away.
Really?
Yeah, but beef too.
What about the pork-based ramen? Can you eat that?
I think it's a little too fatty for my stomach. I can't take it. Like when I go to Korean barbecue, I don't know if this happens to you, but...
Korean barbecue, the fucking... Especially when yesterday the Kobe game, that shit made me like... I still have shits right now.
I always have shits after Korean barbecue.
You from the hot sauce or the kimchi? Or you
no.
I think it's just the protein for me.
I think it's just Koyu King. Other places I don't get the shits, but Koyu King always does. But that's like my favorite place to go to.
Because there's no weight or the flavor?
It's just way too fatty and oily.
Fine. Why are we talking about this? Oh, because you're hungry. True.
He's a hungry wild seal.
What the fuck?
What should you do now?
Just go.
He's biting a little freaking.
What's her belly?
A little lamb chops.
You can hear it too.
She always has a weird smell.
Not anymore.
No, there's times she has it. Like, I feel like if she had a vagina, it would be stinky.
It's only in her armpits.
I don't know. She used to smell like shit. Or like weird.
The doctor was saying she was depressed. And so when she's depressed, her immunity's down, and then she would have like a fungal infection on her skin.
Oh, it was probably the thing on her body, and then we got it shaved off.
the thing. Oh, no, no. She, even before we even knew you.
Oh, she smelled like shit.
Yeah, we used to call her Fungus Fawny.
I probably saved her. Because before me, technically...
She look at his cute little hands. Keep talking.
Before me, she couldn't even come out of your room.
That's funny.
I just like how... She's cool now. She people come in the house, even like people she's never met before, and she'd be chill. Instead of hiding in your room, she will hide in here. That's a big difference.
True. You got that shit out of your eye yet?
No. Okay, no.
You're so fancy, dude.
Well, I'm not sure I lay. I should have relaxed like straight up.
Look at this guy. He looks uncomfortable as fuck.
He looks comfortable right now. Look at him. He's scratching his chin. Legs on a different chair.
If I had to choose between the both positions, I think I'd go with this one.
Obviously, I know how to lean.
Look at your toes, too. Look at your feet.
Nadine told me that in his culture, all the guys, they all lay on the floor with pillows. So he's that's what he told me.
No. So in every
he's been telling a lot of people that information.
Yeah, I mean, it's not a lie, but in a lot of households... They have rooms where just like literally just around all the walls are all like little mattresses and like rug covered mattresses where everyone just sits on and talks gossip.
Yeah, it says all Afghan males, they all just lay on the floor and they smoke hookah and they pass it around with pillows.
They don't barely anyone smokes hookah. They drink tea a lot.
They drink tea and they just
bang hookers.
No, they just they're like everyone.
He can't even lay like you. You're so fancy.
You're just born to relax.
I remember I saw.
He came out of the womb like that.
My dad had an argument like this. I was like, how can you have an argument like this? You know? And he was like pissed. I fucking told you never do that ever. He hit me like this. Come here.
Vaughn's even laughing. You saw him have the argument like that?
Yeah. He was arguing with my uncle or something. I forgot what it was about, but he was just arguing.
Was it those type of fucking enrage arguments where you're spitting? Because you're so passionate about the shit you're saying? Because then that's really angry.
It was about like my uncle cheating during like a fucking poker
that's
game.
That's fucking funny. And what were you doing when you saw him arguing like that?
Because we were just laughing. Because they argue every fucking time over something.
Is it his brother? Or your mom's brother?
My mom's brother.
Oh, shit. Alright. We had a really good day. I think we spent the whole day together. Oh, well, minus the dude.
In the morning, I went to go get the suspension for the truck.
Oh, yeah, tell me about that.
Well, in the morning, I went to get the suspension for the truck.
That's it? Cool. When does it arrive? Do you have it? Is it gonna get installed?
So they order the parts, and it takes about 2 weeks.
Why is that? Why don't they just carry it inside? I feel like every part for a truck, they don't have stock.
Because the things I'm looking for, they're like specialty.
Oh, I see. But well, what does that matter? Also. Oh,
they can't carry everything because not everyone's gonna come and get it. It's not a necessity. It's not like toilet paper. You know, like if it's toilet paper, yeah, you could have 5,000 brands.
So it's made to order.
No, it's they don't have them in stock because they're stocked in like a warehouse. And some of them are made to order, some pieces.
Fine.
And then so I went there and I got suspension and I have like my Chinese side that immediately, once I slid the credit card through.
It hurt.
I regret it already. I was like, fuck, do I need to really spend this much money?
We've been talking about this for so long.
I know, and I was like, should I get the cheaper version? Because there's two versions. One's cheaper. One's more expensive.
That's the two versions. It's not one's nicer, one that has this feature, just
one's
cheaper.
Well, yeah, so one is cheaper and it's not as nice, but I know it's comfortable because that's what I had in my old Tahoe. But then I also got that one in my old Tahoe because I was poor, so I was like, that's all I could afford. And then so I got that, but I know that the ride is nice. But also, the other one that's nice, the one's more expensive and nicer. It's the same company as the shocks that the Raptor has. So that's the reason why I wanted to get that. And then so my other side, where I wanted, the side that I wanted the Raptor, I'm like, oh, cool. Now I have the best of both worlds. I have the truck that I like that looks subtle and still badass. but it has a suspension of a Raptor.
Oh, tight.
But I don't know if it's going to be comfortable. Because some people told me once it's more off-road capable.
It's stiffer.
It's a little bit stiffer because it's made to handle big rocks.
Yeah.
So the little bumps, it's kind of stiff.
Makes sense. So my car and your car are super fucking stiff.
So that's the part that I'm kind of scared of. But overall, I shouldn't be scared because it's not an amount of money that's supposed to like really make me freak out. So we'll see. But it's coming in 2 weeks.
Super cool. So it should be arriving around the same time that the camper.
Yeah. And then so I just sent my truck in. They say that they can install it in a day. And then I'm going to try to schedule a camping trip and take, or even an outdoor just off-roading trip and bring the pups. Because I want to, my dream is to off-road somewhere and then just let them off the leash and let them run around.
Yeah. It's so freaking cute. See them run around free.
I was at the off-road store and there's a picture of a trail on the desk. And I'm like, oh, cool, where's that at? And they call it the El Cajon Trail. And then they say if you off-road up the mountain and you go down the other side, there's a lake.
You know what Cajon means?
No.
If you did I'd be super impressed.
Did you hear what I said?
That's beautiful.
There's a lake.
That sounds beautiful.
But it's a man-made lake.
Cajon means drawer.
Well, it depends on which dialect you're talking about.
There's no dialect, just in Spanish. No,
so in the Mexican Spanish, it means drawer. But if you trace it back to the
Spanish... Look, you're already laughing.
I'm not laughing.
I second this.
The Spanish of Spain, which is the mother country, it's one ball.
Well, an animal or a human?
Human.
Because like, how many cojones do you have?
Yeah, so the cajones.
No, cajon. You already talked.
Cajones. That's two balls. Cajon is
one ball. Uno.
Everyone knows that.
Uno means one. If you guys didn't know.
Yeah.
What the fuck is wrong with that eye? You keep touching that one eye.
I'm scratching. I think I got some fucking hair in it. Dog hair.
But he's still comfortable though. The demon's like just like his dad. He's gonna be one of those guys like he's dying of a heart attack and he's like
when I have my own business, I'm just gonna lay on top of the desk like this.
I pictured you.
You saw my chair before.
Does your brother lay like this too?
Probably, I don't know that. Everybody
does.
It's just
because
it's in the
closet. Dude,
this might be totally fucking racist and completely wrong, but when you said if you own a business and you're going to be laying on your desk like that, I pictured you in like silks, like Aladdin. I basically saw you dressed as Aladdin so with like curly shoes. The rich Aladdin.
That's fine. I don't know how white people just fucking sit like this while they relax like this. It's not comfortable.
Wait, so is Aladdin? Do you relate to Aladdin?
No.
What's so funny? What the hell? What's Aladdin?
Wait. I'm still trying to finish the. This fool said, I don't know how white people are comfortable sitting like this. And he sat like the way we all sit.
But if you come home like
in his world, we're fucking weird.
You're like, yeah, no, you're just
none of us sit like that.
You're like, look at mine right now. You're like, oh, I'm super tired.
No one sits like that. Everyone relaxes. Yeah. Like,
oh shit.
Those are made to lay on. And have them between your legs.
All right.
They got comfortable doing this. Another pose. No matter what pose, the dude always looks.
I think his body was made to lay, for sure.
It's like, I think this is why my body's so fucked up, because like, you see my head position now? It's like when I stand up and when I edit, it's the same thing. So it's perfect. I don't even move.
Oh, Nadim.
Wait, so you don't relate to Aladdin?
Fucking A.
Huh?
You don't relate to Aladdin? You don't see
Aladdin's a cartoon.
No, but like, look, okay, so Mulan, right? I see Mulan, I'm like, oh, cool, that's me. I get it.
They look the same.
Yeah. So for Aladdin, you don't go, that's me?
No, I don't think myself of on a flying carpet and like.
Having no, but that culture though, isn't that close to your culture?
Maybe like 500 years ago.
Yeah, same thing. Mulan is like 500 years ago of me.
That's like fucking like. I feel like.
The meatballs had enough of your bullshit.
Meatball.
Yeah.
Meatloaf.
I know my son's name.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Because you always mix things up all the time.
No, I call him Meatball and I call him Meaty.
No, there's times when I'm supposed to make a right. Go, make a left. Make a left. I'm like, I didn't make a left. I mean, right. So I know you get things mixed up all the time.
Well, this one was done on purpose. Okay.
Well, he's not Meatball because we might have another dog and his name might be Meatball.
But I like calling him Meatball and Meaty.
What are you guys going to name your son? Tarantula?
Tarantula?
Yeah, you guys said you wanted to name it Tarantula.
What are you doing with your hands now? What the hell?
They're laying on each other. He's laying on each other. You should get little cotton balls or little pillows on your fingers.
Mom said the fingers are the most important thing to wear.
I know, and you got the cutest ones. Look at that shit. Look at his fingers.
Buff. I worked them out.
Wait, so you don't really...
Oh that? My god!
you don't go, that's my ancestors.
No.
What?
Not even the genie? The genie was pretty real.
The genie, I was like, oh shit, that's like my uncle. But
no, there's gotta be. So, okay.
There's gotta be.
So who relates to Aladdin then? Arabic people?
Maybe some, maybe Persians.
So that's more of a Persian story.
Maybe. I have no idea.
It's not an Arabic story?
It's based off that region, of course.
Middle East, right?
Yeah. That's it.
But you're also Middle Eastern.
Yeah.
So it would kind of relate to you, because it's like, it's that region.
Let me think.
Because I see Mulan, and I go, okay, that's that relates to me. I get it. Even Kung Fu Panda a little bit, even though it's not a panda, but like the culture.
But it's like Mulan just fought people, you know. Fucking Aladdin was riding on the carpet talking to a monkey.
I can show you the world.
But like the
whole thing is pretty fantasy.
The whole thing was fantasy.
Well, but there's like a sultan.
Oh yeah, and then that, like, of course, there's a sultan in like Middle Eastern and Arabic culture.
Yeah.
That's it?
And you also have Arabic. Do you practice the Arabic culture?
The Quran is only in Arabic. There's no other interpretation of it.
So if you practice the Quran, you practice the Arabic culture.
Yeah, so even if we don't speak Arabic, we can learn how to...
Sorry, guys.
Learn how to read and write in Arabic.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Do you speak Arabic? No?
No.
Only Farsi?
Barely, yeah.
So if someone is not from Afghanistan, they're from somewhere else, but they're Arabic, you relate to them. It's like, okay, we're both Arabic.
I would say we're both Muslim.
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 Wait, how do you say it?
Muslim.
Muslim.
So Muslim?
But then where does the Arabic come in then?
It's just the... So where the Quran was written, it was written originally in Arabic.
Yeah.
And then everyone spread apart, whatever happened. People that became Muslim.
Muslim.
All over the world. Because you cannot interpret the Quran... There's no real words, like say there's a word for this in the Quran, in Arabic, you can't interpret it in English, it's going to mean something else, right? So everyone learned how to, even if they don't speak Arabic,
yeah.
We speak Farsi, but we learn how to read and write in Arabic because of that.
But then so when you meet another Arab, like you feel connected with them?
Because they're Muslim.
Because they're Muslim.
Yeah.
So you don't practice the Arab culture?
No. Oh, I practiced culture I was born and raised in.
American.
Which is?
American. No, Afghan.
Afghan-American
yeah.
Muslim.
Afghan-Muslim.
Afghan-Muslim-American.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, Aladdin is American. Speaks American. He speaks American.
It was probably written by Americans.
Speaks American.
Yeah.
And he's probably Muslim. So you relate 2/3.
Yeah.
I didn't see him eat pork or anything like that. Did he? He didn't eat a pork.
I saw him eat bread, a roll of bread.
Yeah. He was a thief.
Oh, Afghans for sure are not thieves.
Iraqis. I'm just joking.
We're all just joking.
Now I was wondering if he relates to him or not.
No, we got that. We got that you were wondering that.
Who
Or like what in pop culture do you go, oh, that's me?
Oh, that's me?
Yeah, there's gotta be like something in pop culture like that's me.
Have you seen like these Food Network channels? Where they're eating food, I'm like, that's me.
That's dope.
I'd say like you saw Lone Survivor?
Yes.
So of course then that showed you there's bad people, but then there was the good villagers that even though they it was America and they took him in and they protected him because that's what you do.
Yeah.
That's you.
That's us.
Tight.
But what about like when you first saw Yusef on YouTube, were you like, that's me?
Yusef?
Yeah.
Are we like, that's a shade closer to me?
Yeah, just because of the Muslim part.
There's always Muslims, that's closer to me than pretty much half of the people on YouTube.
Yeah.
Well, that's tight.
I mean, everyone's like, you know, like same thing that why you didn't reveal your ethnicity because you didn't want to
seem segregate.
Like, yeah, just like, then you would have just like, basically, the Chinese would have claimed you for... Yeah. Being Chinese, like, oh, look, he's Chinese, that's why his name.
Yeah.
You know, I think when, like, the Muslim people do it, everyone, they just get a huge Muslim following.
Yeah.
But then Yusef broke out and did other things and became big in every culture.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. But it's cool to see, like, a Muslim because it is, there's really nothing on YouTube for them.
Yeah. Yeah, because even for me, like, when I was keeping a secret in the beginning, when I first saw Wong Fu, I was like, oh, that's me. You know, like, because I'm just like, oh, cool, that's dope. There's another Chinese-American doing something on YouTube.
That was me with Eric, the Cholos and shit. Not the Cholos aspect, but just someone that spoke Spanish, but was Mexican-American. I was like, oh, that's tight, that's me.
I think I
also see myself. Me and Joe's Cholo characters, you didn't go, oh, that's me?
Never.
Why?
Because it's fake.
But we're more Cholo, more real Cholo than Eric. And his buddy.
Maybe, but you guys were making up a lot of Spanish, so I couldn't relate to that. That's not me.
I think I related more to you guys. Like Asians.
Yeah.
Because I hung out with a lot of Asians, but yeah. Also you guys were... Or not just you guys alone, but you guys were... There was you guys, there was Wong Fu, there was Camp Jamba, there was Nigga Higa. Those were like Tim the Ghetto. Everyone I followed was Asian. They were like the people that were like the funniest and the biggest.
True. At that time, they were just, like, it was predominantly Asian. Yeah,
because it was, like, the people, like nowadays, you go to an event, like, you have the cool people, right? We don't get along with the typical cool people. We get along with, like, people like us, you know?
Yeah.
Like, even, like, the Asian people or the Asian culture, they got along with each other. They did stuff that people didn't really think were cool, but, like, YouTube was like a huge outlet for them to blow up on. I think that's why I followed a lot of Asians. Because they like a lot of Asians where they just like to mess around and have fun.
That's true.
Alright.
Do you miss doing all those characters?
I miss doing characters, not necessarily the old characters. Just because I think once you do a character a lot, as an artist, you kind of feel like, okay, I feel like I've accomplished everything I can in this character, so now it's time to move on and make another character. It's kind of like, the first Borat could be hella funny, but after you do like 12 Borat movies, you know, yeah. You're like, I'm kind of want to move on and do another character.
Is there any character that you felt like I didn't get a fully act?
Yeah, there's a lot, especially the ones that don't look that Asian. But I feel like we could do it really. Like, we had this one called Rattlesnake Jake and Applesauce the Boss. It's because since we don't. Like, since we look Asian, the most believable characters are going to be the Asian ones. Yeah. So, unless we have a crazy good, like, makeup team, like the way Key and Peele does, where they can play, like, Middle Eastern, play Latino, play black and white, you know.
It's always gonna look super slapsticky.
It's just gonna look cartoony, like.
But I feel like, because you guys are a minority, you guys could play other minorities pretty good. And you grew up with the Cholos, so you did Cholos pretty good. You guys did that, like the Arab car parts salesman.
Yeah.
Pretty good. I think
Ahmad Vagisil is his name, excuse you.
Say it again.
Ahmad Vagisil.
Ahmed. That's how you pronounce it.
Ahmed. What about his last name?
How do you say it?
Vagisil.
Vagisil. This was his last name?
Yeah.
You know what Vagisil is?
Yeah.
It's just fucking your badge, right?
Yeah.
No, but it's actual, like, a yeast infection cream.
Vagisil. But I feel like you guys doing the white person is, like, the end of the spectrum, you know?
Yeah.
The complete opposite. I think that's, like...
They only know how to do one style of white person, too.
The redneck?
Oh, two styles.
We know a lot of different styles.
They know the Mr. Peterson style.
I see them do a lot of...
There's a lot of different white people.
There is a lot of different white people. I said you only know two of them.
We could do a ton of them. We could do bro, we could do surfer, we could do...
All right, fine.
Redneck. We could do Mr. Peterson, we could do, like, professor, we could do a British guy.
Wait, professor's not white. What the fuck?
But, like, a more...
Surfers aren't white.
Yeah, they are.
No, it's not. What are you talking about?
Surfers? When I think of surfer, I think, like, hey, bro.
Yeah,
but that's Hawaiian, foe.
No,
the white people copied them.
They did, but...
You see, when there's a surfer movie, they're always white.
Well, because it's in America.
Hawaii's in America?
No, it is. It is, but Japanese were in Hawaii.
But they're not surfing.
They're not surfing.
What are you talking about?
They're Hawaiian people. Surfboards in half with karate chops.
All right, I'm going to go to sleep now. Thanks so much for watching our night. These guys are getting crazy. Till next time.
I hope it was even recording.
You're amazing. I think you're a beast.
Am I a beast in bed?
You're a cat, huh?
Am I a beast in bed?
Look at that.
What?
Look how pretty all that is. The dogs would love that.
Is that what you see when I make you orgasm?
What emptiness?